Praise the Lord, everybody. I'm back bringing you more of the things that God has done. I want to share a testimony today that pertains to the tribulations and the trials and the persecutions that I've had on the job. And I know that our workplace is a great place to win souls. It's a great place to be a light. It's a great place to demonstrate the love and the peace of God. And it's a great place where God will refine us and cause us to grow. He'll cause us to suffer long and yet be kind. He'll cause us to overcome evil with good. He'll cause us to bless those who despitefully use us. He's always trying to teach us something in the midst of the trials, the tests, the temptations, and the tribulations and persecution. For the Lord has said, everyone that will live godly shall suffer persecution. We must have this expectation because the Spirit of the Lord dwells in you. And because he do, the enemy is going to try to bring you down every opportunity that he gets. But what the devil meant for good, for bad, what the devil meant for bad, God meant for good. And he would turn it into good. Because again, the word of the Lord says that all things work together for the good, for those who love God and are called according to his purpose. Well, on my job that I had a few years ago, I was ministering. I was working a second shift, and being a supervisor, I had the ability to walk around and talk as I was on receiving, and I had many employees that worked for me, generally 50 or more, and I would minister every opportunity I got. And I had to balance the difference between being a supervisor and sharing the word, ministering at the same time. And I prayed constantly for God's wisdom in it. So I ended up getting quite a few gentlemen to come to church. And I began to start this prayer group at midnight. And we had this nice conference room there. And being oftentimes the supervisor in charge of the building, I took advantage and I began to start a prayer group at midnight. We had a midnight break. And we would go up. It was only about 8 of us, including myself. We would go up and began to pray. I would share a few words of encouragement. And then we join hands and we go before the Lord. And I've done that consistently. And my supervisor, the one that will work with me on second shift, I began to minister to them. It was two. And both of them I ministered to and prayed with. And one of them, he really locked in and began to love the Lord and got him saved. And every night when we left, we'd go out to the vehicle and we'd pray. It was a blessing. But so it just so happened that there was some that didn't appreciate the fact that I was gathering these seven in the conference room to pray. So the word got out to HR and to the director, and they brought me in and gave me what was called a letter of instructions. It was a write-up, but it wasn't a verb. It wasn't a normal write-up. It was a conversation that was put in writing. And they told me that because I represent the company, that I couldn't do that, that one of the employees had to do that. And it was a form of tribulation for me. It was disappointing that I couldn't do it anymore. It was a blessing, and I was glad, and I thought upon it, and I have rejoiced because God is good, and I was able to plant a lot of seeds in the workplace. And it was a major blessing there. One of the supervisors got in trouble, and he was going to be terminated the next day. So we thought, anyway. So that night we prayed, and I took his hands and we sat in our chair. I began to ask the Lord to intercede and bless him. And the power of God began to move through his hands and was going through his body. And we got through praying, and he began to talk about how he had never experienced the power of God, the presence of God upon him in such a way. But unfortunately, the next morning, he was released. And I thank God for the opportunity to pray with him. And the time we shared on the job and the blessings. But tribulations comes in the workplace. Even now, where I work, I've had many speak words of negativity and profanity, and in an indirect way, say negative and harsh things that oftentimes I feel like is directed at me. But in the midst of it all, the Lord has taught me to pray for them, as well as write their names down. And my wife and I, we intercede for them on a regular basis. And things has gotten much better. I had an option. I mean, I could have went to EEO and begin to cause all kind of friction in the workplace. But I held my peace, and I'm holding my peace, and I'm believing God for a mighty change in the workplace. And he's taught me to hold on to peace and to trust him and to pray for those who despitefully use you and to bless those that curse you and to continually speak to them. Anytime someone come against you or begin to mock and scorn and be talebearers and gossipers and slanderers, and those things, and they say stuff and laugh and want to make you feel that they're ridiculing you, and oftentimes they will be, it's an indication that God is doing a thing in your life and that his hand is upon you, and he wants you to be able to endure hardness as a good soldier in the Lord. And believe you me, at the end, he got a blessing for you. He wants you to get to the next level. He don't want you to faint and become bitter, and become angry, and become resentful, and become unforgiving, because this is exactly what the enemy wants for your life. He wants a root of bitterness to spring up in you. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 12 that a root of bitterness springing up, which defiles many. And Satan knows the word, and he will do anything in his power to get you off track, to get you to fall back into perdition and fall away from our Lord and our Savior. But stand strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, and know that God is with you. Good news, you're surrounded by angels. Put them to work in the workplace. Go to your workplace and begin to pray. Pray in the spirit. Decree and declare a thing. Those guys around you, God wants them to make it into heaven also. Let them see a light in you that they've never seen before. Let your light shine so much that they will see your good works and give God all the glory. Be a blessing. Hallelujah. I want to read a scripture tonight, or today, rather, and hopefully encourage you, because I know if you're living godly, persecution is coming your way. The Bible says all that will live godly shall suffer persecution. It got to be an expectation. So we got to learn how to defend ourselves in the spirit and count it all joy. James chapter 1, verse 2. My brethren, count it all joy when ye fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. So the Lord is trying to increase patience. He wants us to be able to endure. He wants us to be able to persevere. And the Bible says, after you have suffered for a while, May you be settled, established, perfected. He want to settle us. He want to perfect us. He want us to be stable, that we're able to endure hardship and to continue to function and continue to be effective in the kingdom. Hallelujah. He wants to be able to cast down imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. And you are able to do it. We are able to do it through Christ. But the Bible says we can do all things through Christ who give us the strength. Hallelujah. And nothing is impossible with the Lord. All things are possible unto him that believe. And thank God. And I thank you for listening once again. And we bless the name of Jesus. And I'm going to pray for strength and for ability and for wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you now for grace to be able to endure hardship and hardness as good soldiers in you. Teach us, Lord, to be warriors in the spirit, to decree a thing that it shall be so. We thank you for the Holy Ghost, our comforter, our teacher, our guide. He that show us things to come. Help us, Lord, to pray for those who despitefully use us, Lord, to bless those that curse us and to overcome evil with good, knowing that you will avenge us. Help us and strengthen us, God. And give us the ability to be still, to know that you're God and there's none like you. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless with exceeding joy in the presence of his glory. Unto the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Thank you for listening. God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.